With Tage back there on Tracer, obviously down now, but in general, just to keep both their supports alive. So that'll be the challenge for Mercy's Angels.
Somebody needs to account for Flatpup. Flatpup is doing a wonderful job on that Pharah, but he's just controlling this map right now. Absolutely dominant.
And that flips trip coming in with the tactical visor, able to grab a double, and that may slow down this attack, at least don't temporarily. I believe that was Earthbound not quite painting out, and now we'll fall there. But a Flatpup again, just going off of feed, getting a good three there, and combining with Freakalicious to take down some out of Meg.
He is getting healed up by Guild Capital. Guild Capital, 64, 65, 66% on that Mercy Valkyrie, just doing a nice job there.
I ignore that ult entirely, and I like the reaction time there from him. I'm still on the point, 62% gone for Bjorn to kill, and this round going very quickly.
Kyle does follow the kill on Raging Bull and the Alexio, so it should, this should be Brick Squad's point.
Waiting to hold on to a third at Fungo and make him pay for Nike using his super. Both supports going down as the economy and Spartan Wells fall. Leonidas answers back, taking down Hypertoad and Kyle Gunner with a fantastic D.Va bomb. And the fight really breaking out right here at the choke as we're folks trying to keep everybody solvent. And now Sarge going into the back with a solid double there on the Death Blossom. We grab a couple Psychro answers with a double on his own. Sir Roaster picks one up again on that. And we grab this point up for 35.
Try to grab on Surge. Earth Shatter coming up with the Alexio. Doesn't really buy much. Graviton Surge. This looks like it should be a clean team wipe.
Yeah, just first one though. Relentless in their attack. Getting good shadow on Leonidas there, was there at Fun Boy. We'll be able to take him down.
The Deadeye not getting anything. And getting tagged up. Finally, Fixer going in the way.
Hello and welcome to the Overwatch X League All-Star Game. I'm your host, Salt and Pepper. Joined by Raging Bull, SMK, Rewinds, and Pivo. Ready to get this game kicked off? How are you guys doing today?
I'm doing great, Sultan. How are you boys doing?
Doing great.
I'm doing fine, mighty fine.
I'm excited to get this game kicked off. Between Team Jockey, Dirty Jockey 19's team, and Sabuki's team, Team Civ, compiled from the best players in the league as voted by the captains, and in this game on this great Sunday night, we're excited to get it started for you. We do have a few substitutions coming in now from a few players that you saw in the video that won't be able to join us, but we do still have some solid squads for you, and getting ready to start here. We will be on Oasis first, and I think everybody's ready to go, so yeah, let's get started. Guys, what do you think of Oasis?
Just real quick, let's give it up for Sultan and his video production. Fantastic video. I'm freaking hyped for the All-Star game. This is going to be a ton of fun, guys. What do you say?
It's going to be fantastic, man. Great job on the video. I was like, saw my fellow teammates playing. I'm very biased, but I think they're good. I think they're very good.
Thanks, guys. Before we start this game, did we want to lock Parallax to Jockey's team?
I think he's on. Good point.
Yeah.
There we go. Good call. Make sure everybody is lined up. We do have a lot of players waiting in the wings to get an opportunity to play in this game. We will do four maps. We're starting on Oasis. We'll do Havelskaya, Junkertown, and I believe Eichenwald. I'm not sure about the order, but we'll get that for you. But yeah, team's ready to go, itching to get this game started. So let's kick it off and get to Oasis.
To answer your question, Sultan, I do like Oasis. Oasis is a very fun King of the Hill map. It's sort of untraditional, as we've seen a lot of Ilios or Lijiang Tower being played. This one doesn't really have as much elements for environmental kills. There's one map or so that has that, but otherwise, I really like Oasis. Should be a lot of fun.
Yep, these games definitely go back and forth. It's never one-sided on this map.
Well, I'm expecting some Pharah to be played. This is a very good Pharah map, and a lot of Varia battles. And I think we have some Pharah players, right, on the plane right now? Nice.
There's a few players that they can play Pharah. We don't get to see a lot of Pharah.
Yeah.
Or at least a lot of Oasis, rather, so I'm excited to be later on. First control point here. Sorry, what were you saying, people?
No, I'm seeing some Moira on the enemy team, on the red team, so I'm very happy right now.
You've got both of your captains picking their traditional players. Dirty Jockey on that Tracer, Firing Wolf on the Lucio, Gale Capital on the Mercy, Greatest Gen M on the D.Va, Third Eye Funk Boy on the Reinhardt, Rayquaza on the McCree, and then Savuki's team, formerly Sivaris. He is playing that McCree. Kyle Gunner, interestingly enough, playing that Zarya. Just Buck on the Lucio, Time Lord Prime on that Tracer. That should be a lot of fun to watch him versus Dirty Jockey. Bodily on the Moira, and Psych Raw playing some nice D.Va, boys. Let's see how this game takes off.
I immediately see Civ's team coming around the outside of point. Looks like both teams coming in the same direction, beating immediately, and obviously nobody wanted to drop off too quickly here. Taking a little bit of high ground, Team Civ with Spooky there, and I believe that's Time Lord with him. Just trying to get a little bit of high ground, a little bit of damage, and Gale Capital already in a difficult spot as Psychroth finds him on the D.Va, low health, and tries to get away. Maybe he'll survive there, but Civ is the first to fall, being his opposite captain, Dirty Jockey, taking him down. And as the control point starts to open up, it looks like Jockey's team actually does have a little bit of an advantage here. Civ's team kind of backing off, and as the control point starts to develop a little bit of that blue, we'll see if Civ's team backs off here or tries to maintain the contest.
Yeah, Civ going down so early by Dirty Jockey, being pocketed by that Mercy, absolutely to be taken into account for. But you see, they're really trying to climb back here. Civ does take out Dirty Jockey, answers that. Third Eye Funk Boy on the Reinhardt takes him out. And now it is blue team, Dirty Jockey and company. They do take this first point. Let's see how Savuki's team comes back.
Interesting to see Civ fall so early there, but recognizing a threat and taking him down immediately did help them win that fight. And now with about 20% or so, we'll see them start to come back in and engage. A few walls building here for the currently defending team. Dirty Jockey with a pulse bomb, the same one on the opposite side, but Time Lord Firing Wolf with a sound barrier, Gale Capital with Valkyrie as well, and Rayquaza there with a Deadeye. Alts starting to build here for Civ's team, still kind of disadvantaged. Gale will now use the Valkyrie to pick Third Eye back up, and then we'll purchase the res. He's strong on the point. What do you see?
Boy, Sturdy Jockey is going for Savuki as much as he can. He wants his blood so badly. This is incredible. You see, he used his pulse bomb on Savuki. Boom. Gets his pulse bomb back within 10, 15 seconds. Unbelievable. Savuki does have Deadeye. I see him using it now. And one, two, does pick off Fireball. Does pick off Rayquaza. And Greatest Gen M with the D.Va ult to take out Savuki.
And here about 64-65%. Looks like Civ's team coming back in and trying to take this point back, but already quite a bit of it earned here for Jockey's team. They're defending well, still with a few alts in their pocket, four to be exact. Civ's team still looking to build a few Just T-Buck. Took that sound barrier off, looking to, or has a sound barrier here and could use it to help out his team with the shadow coming in.
That's a very nice stall by the blue team. It's like really good.
Very nice job by Savuki and company. Go ahead and take that team back. As you can see, Psych Raw is on fire, does have their D.Va cart back. Just Buck does have that very precious Lucio sound barrier. Let's see what they can do about this. He will be answered by Firing Wolf playing the Lucio on Dirty Jockey's team. So this should be quite the fight that we're about to see break out. You can see Savuki sitting on top of that high ground, does roll off, does give it out to Rayquaza. Dirty Jockey looking for Savuki. He's like, I gotta kill him, and he does. Takes out Savuki very quickly. Pretty impressive, if you ask me.
Yeah, now going in on Bo, really able to eliminate him as well, and two big picks here for Dirty Jockey in his fight to try and take this back. Sakura out of Mech Guardian in a difficult spot as well, and as the kills start going the way of Team Jockey, they may be able to wrap this up and flip the point back before Civ hits 50% or so.
Absolutely. Gale Capital does pop that Mercy ult, and he is trying to keep that team healed up as best as they can. They do take the point back, 87-88%. Savuki's team does need to regroup. They need to get together as a team. I see them sort of trickling in a little bit. That has not favored them whatsoever. If they want to try to take this point back, they really need to group up. And big pulse bomb on that Mercy by Dirty Jockey.
Yeah, that's a huge pulse bomb of Bitly. Not able to use the Valkyrie, 99% away, now has it, but will be contesting with the respawn. So we'll want to try and get back to point as quickly as possible, but not a lot of control over being able to get back, obviously. Justy Bucks trying to continue this contest here and flip the point back for Team Civ, but Team Jockey still looks like they are kind of supreme on the point. Actually, Bone Billy does come back, is able to use the Valkyrie to pick up Savuki. That's a big pickup for them. Kyle Gunner comes back as well. Savuki pays him back by taking down his opposite McCree, Breakways, and in overtime, he'll flip that point back turn for more percentage.
I feel like this is a battle of giants right now. Time Lord Prime doing some work on that Tracer, taking out Dirty Jockey. There's a lot of fun things happening right here. I hope that we're able to catch all of it because, my goodness, every player on this team, they're all all-stars. They're playing at high caliber. This is a ton of fun.
Yeah, the battle between these Tracers trying to find the essential picks is interesting to watch so far. Dirty Jockey back at it, trying to get Civ up at the top with Bo Billy pocketing him there. And Civ again in a difficult spot, but Dirty Jockey having to recall, they're getting a little bit low on health. Civ looking to find health of his own. Dirty Jockey picks up that pulse bomb, just to get in on somebody. Justy Buck there falling as Time Lord is able to grab Geld Capital with the pulse bomb as well. This time doesn't quite connect for Dirty Jockey, though, is able to take out Spooky regardless.
Yeah, unfortunately, with that Mercy pick just doesn't do enough for Time Lord and company. They are able to take that point. Dirty Jockey is, and what a battle between two heavyweight teams. SNK Piva, what did you boys see in that match?
Well, Civ got shut down fairly often, so that was the thing. He was not doing anything for the first times. Like, Dirty Jockey was going for his ass all the time. And I think Civ's team played a little bit too passively for the first two team fights. So they had the numbers advantage on point, but they backed off, and then the Dirty Jockey team just capped the point. And then if they had to be a little bit more aggressive, I think they'll be able to cap it at least the first time.
Same here. Civ's team's not staying together. Just, they're playing all over the place. Dirty Jockey's team seems to be playing more together than Civ's. So
I would absolutely agree with that. I did see Civ's team doing some trickle, but here we are off to the second map here on Oasis. Savuki's team taking that high ground very, very quickly. Now, Dirty Jockey's team, they are fighting for that teleporter or that airlift there. So let's see how this goes out. Savuki's team is pulling back, and there could be some big plays happening here very quickly. Kyle Gunner taking out the Grace Gen M. Time Lord cleaning up that D.Va as soon as she got out of mech, and he takes out that Reinhardt. Big picks by Time Lord Prime. That's my boy on Beats by Lucio.
Yeah, putting a
hashtag bias.
Already 78% or now 88%. Great, keep up with it. 2-8 pulse bomb. We'll be able to use that in this next engagement. Dirty Jockey's opposite only at 64% or so. So already seeing who's winning that battle of finding central targets and taking them down to help the teams win the fight.
Now, but Savuki has claimed that high ground. We all know that he is a man of on high, and that high is the high ground. And it looks like Third Eye Funk Boy is leading the charge with the Reinhardt, just keeping that shield up, followed by Kyle Gunner. Not seeing Kyle Gunner play on D.Va is fairly interesting. Cycross sending in that D.Va bomb does not get anybody, and they need to quickly regroup. I do see Kyle Gunner just sort of swinging in, and he needs to pull back, and he does get picked, unfortunately. But he does get rezzed up by Bo Diddley, and lots of action happening right now here at the blue team spawn point.
Yeah, I like the aggressive defense here from Civ's team, pushing up after having taken the point. They're already up to about 50% or so. We'll be here shortly, and just keeping Jockey's team pushed back and not really giving them an opportunity to collect any kind of purchase on the point here. Bo Diddley using our play scale capital, but using the Valkyrie, trying to keep the team alive as they continue this engagement in the... I think Soundbear then comes in from Justy Buck as well, just trying to keep Civ's team alive here as this attack comes in. Firing Wall falls, but then is Rez, Third Eye Funk Boy falls as well. And still looks like a pretty good defense here for Civ's team. Jockey's just not able to push in maybe as well as it'd like.
Oh, wow, a couple of high noons going off. I don't think they could tell the time right because neither of them did connect. Another big Diva Bomb coming in. Kyle Gunner does shield that off with his Reinhardt play. We did see a couple of smashes that did connect but didn't really follow through with anything. These two teams need to play a little bit more cohesively if they want to use their ults appropriately. But lots of big action happening. And there goes Psychraw taking off Rayquaza. Kyle Gunner picking off Third Eye Funk Boy on that Rhyne v Rhyne, and Time Lord Prime taking out that Mercy. Great job by Time Lord Prime to take out that essential healer for Dirty Jockey's team. I have not seen much play happening from Dirty Jockey right now, and that's because Savuki's team is just putting on a clinic, and they are going to capture this point, and it is all tied 1-2-1.
Well, what a response right there from Civ's team coming back after a really hotly contested first round, and just able to take that point 100-0. And I like the, like I said, aggressive defense from them pushing back out from the point, and Jockey's team just did not know how to contest with that defense.
Pivo, SNK, what'd you two think? What'd you guys see?
Oh, I saw some great diva work from the two divas in the both teams, like blocking the high noons when Rayquaza's, I don't know how to say his name, he actually got out of the high ground and he dropped down, and the diva Psychraw was on the point, like the defense matrix, and just flew out to his face and kill him. That was a great play.
Sif's team was definitely playing a lot more closer together than the first game. Dirty Jockey's team was just a little more spread out than his team. Obviously.
As a theme that we see, if you are a team, you are together, and if you are together, you seem to have a higher chance of winning the game. Here we are on to map number 3 of Oasis. This will decide the map. We have Dirty Jockey and Savuki going against each other. Let's see how this first point falls to which team. Ooh, Kyle Gunner looked like he went AFK there for a second, and he is back.
And again, already really aggressive push from Team Civ, but it's actually Jockey's team that starts getting a little bit of the advantage, and looks like they may be able to just about to cap this point if they can knock off these last straggling attackers. But I like that Civ's team did come in just as aggressively as they did on the last point and started taking a little bit of that progress, but then just couldn't hold on as well, lost the members they needed to take that point, and Jockey's team has a little bit to hold on to now.
Yeah, if Savuki's team wants to pull this back, they do need to regroup. I've seen a couple of stragglers and they got picked off, and that could just be game awareness, and they knew that they needed to get picked off so they could all rejoin together, and that looks like exactly what's about to happen here. So Kyle Gunner is going to be leading the way on that Reinhardt, followed by Psychraw on that Diva. They're going through the left side, and they're going to try and get some early picks here and try and take this point back. It is 30-0 Dirty Jockey's team on this third and final point of Oasis.
A little bit of poke damage in from behind Dirty Jockey. Looks like that pulse bomb does quite connect. And now just looking to get a little bit more damage in and build that pulse bomb
big
back
smash.
Up in a contest here with Time Lord. Not quite able to pick him down, but now ult coming out on the point from either side. The self-destruct comes in, does connect with Rayquaza. Now it's still, it looks like Civ's team getting the kills in the feed. Looks like they will be able to flip this point back and cap here. Dirty Jockey's team just eclipsing 50%.
Time Lord Prime saying Old McDonald had a farm EIEIO because he is farming Dirty Jockey's team right now. My goodness. Him on Tracer is a thing to watch, folks. I hope you're getting some action of that because he is playing fantastic. Lots of good action happening right now. Dirty Jockey's team about to come back to the point. Kyle Gunner swinging big as that Reinhardt, getting pocketed by that Mercy as is necessary when you've got an aggressive Reinhardt. And Just Buck look like he's trying to boop some people back. There comes a sound barrier coming in hot. And lots of action happening early. Savuki takes out Third Eye Funk Boy, and Geld Capital does fall on that Mercy. Dirty Jockey's team is sort of getting staggered right now, and they need to regroup if they even want to think about taking this third and final point.
And they start out the map really strongly, getting up to 52%, but again, this aggressive defense from Team Civ pushing them out back into their own spawn area is making it really difficult for them to get as close to the point as they'd like to start to be able to contest. It may just be a matter of having to come in with ults. They've got greatest gen M's. Graviton they could use to combine possibly with the pulse bomb from Dirty Jockey, see what they're trying to come out with. But still 5 ults on the side of Team Civ, so they can always use those to defend just as well.
No doubt. Third Eye Funk Boy. Big smash coming in from Kyle Gunner. Does take out that Mercy. Smashes into Geld Capital. Time Lord Prime with that Tracer Pulse Bomb on Rayquaza. Savuki taking out Firing Wolf. And Kyle Gunner finalizing that team fight on Third Eye Funk Boy. Fantastic job by Savuki's team right now controlling this point and doing some work.
Yeah, now is the time to start sticking up here. 85% gone on the point for Team Civ. Jockey teams will have to figure out a better way to come in. And I believe this kind of middle section, this middle push for them, is not quite working out. They need to try and find another way to go. I have somebody coming underneath, but an early pin in here onto a third eye funk boy from Kyle Gunner will make that difficult. The Graviton comes out and does grab a couple, but I don't know if they have damage to go with it. As I say, that dirty jockey coming in with a triple pulse bomb too. Back to the start, wiping this team. They're getting a little bit of progress back in the point, and they will be able to flip this point back at the death at 99%.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, that was a huge pulse bomb. Savuki's team just got completely wiped off the map. Dirty Jockey is on fire, as you can see, and you can understand why. Big picks happening by Dirty Jockey and company. Third Eye Funk Boy with a big Reinhardt smash. Unfortunately, they do not have any more ults at this time. Firing Wolf at the closest at 87% on that Lucio. But Savuki's team, you know, Kyle Gunner is going to be coming with that smash in about 30, and Bo Diddley does have his Mercy ult. So we'll see if they use these effectively to win this point back.
Yeah, we'll see how Jockey's team decides to defend this point. They are sitting a little further back, and actually, Civ team is able to push in as a result. Shatter comes in, but actually connects with four, but then he falls and is not able to use that as effectively as he would have liked to, but they're now using that Valkyrie just to keep Civ's team alive on the point as it starts to eclipse to about 99% with the final round here on Oasis on the line. So Team Civ is wrapping this back up. Looks like we'll be able to flip the point back to Dirty Jockey on Trace, who looks to contest last second.
Whoa.
Isn't quite able to keep from going, but Fire Wolf coming back in keeps the overtime timer alive. Everybody else trickling back in as the stars come down. I don't know if Third Eye Funk will be able to get in time, but Dirty Chalk is still able to contest to some degree. The rest of the team coming back in, looking to see if they can just keep the contest up just long enough to win this fight. But as the overtime meter ticks down, it looks like it will be Team Civ that takes the first point.
Fantastic job. You saw Civ. He said, you know what, boy? I saw you hit me. You hit me first on the first map. The second map, I got you. And the third map, you were trying to contest and pop, pop, pop right to the dome. They were able to take that third and final point of Oasis. And Team Savuki is up 1-0.
Yeah, and obviously really impressive plays on both sides. Seeing that triple there from Dirty Jockey on Graviton helped them get a little bit of progress back at this point to push to a 99 overtime, but not able to get it over the line as Team Civ takes the first round on Oasis. So it's impressive for them, but we'll get additional thoughts here in a second. We'll take a break at the next map pick, and yeah, we'll be right back.
He can hear.
Hey, welcome back. Yeah, just a really solid game there on the last point. Obviously, highly contested between both teams, and just slightly edging out there. Team Civ able to take that first win. I believe Volskaya will be the next map we'll go to. Yeah, just what do you guys think of that last map? Get SNK and P with us.
Well, I liked that they proved that ult economy is something overrated, because who needs ult economy when you use all of your ults at the same time? both team fights, when the teams got wiped, they just use everything, and they maybe like kept one sound barrier that they didn't use. But I mean, if you wipe the team, you don't need to have ults, right? So it's good.
Very good point.
It was a tightly contested between both teams. Like to see a good game like that. So obviously, team or old economies wins games, but you don't need it, apparently. I don't know.
I mean, if you're going to wipe everybody, just like use everything and then just like, yeah, you know what? I'm just going to kill you like right now. So use bombs and then Diva bomb and Tracer bomb and then Deadeye. Just use everything. Yeah. You're going to die anyway.
Yeah.
We're able to make it work, though. really did like to see the Dirty Jockey kind of like, he had to kind of contest with a few. I think Civ was giving him problems, and obviously Time Lord was as well, so I kind of had to split his attention a little bit. And I don't know if Rayquaza was playing McCree up to the same level as Savuki, or kind of giving those flankers as much of a problem when he was playing McCree, so that could have been an issue as well. But yeah, just excited that that game went the way it did, obviously. All-Star game. Want to see some of the best players, and so yeah, it's not the first game. Looks like there will be a substitution. Greatest Gen M coming out for Parallax. Parallax on the All-Natty team that won the Tier 2 championship against Mercy's Angels.
And we also have another substitution coming in, Don Jiggy for Bo Bib.
Yeah, kind of a like for like support. Don Jiggy plays a lot of, I believe Zen Lucio, if I'm not mistaken. But Billy with a few supports in his locker as well. What do you think the advantages will be for either team on Volskaya?
Volskaya, in my opinion, I think it's going to be another Tracer v Tracer matchup. Watching Time Lord Prime on Tracer previously on the previous map was fantastic, and we know what Dirty Jockey can do. He is an absolutely filthy Tracer when he wants to be. So I see a lot of diving on the supports that we had seen previously to go along with that. But this should be a lot of fun. Not too many people actually like 2CP, but I am one of those people that do kind of like it. It's a lot of fun to watch. So we'll see how this one turns out.
Absolutely.
Just the problem with 2CPs is that they get snowballed very often, right?
Well, what do you mean? They're like, the A point's obviously easy to take, but then like, that B point is a bit of a battle of attrition for a while.
Yeah, it's like the maps are usually like, for the first point is really favors the attackers, and then the point B is always favoring the defense team. So it's always this like two-sided thing, depending on if you can flank them, especially for Volskaya. If you can get somebody on the point and like distract them and pull them off choke or whatever the defensive position is, you can actually cap that point fairly quick if the team is not paying attention.
That's a good point. You do have some really long 2CPs getting to 3 and 4 rounds, some 25-minute games, but we'll see which direction this one goes. I think everyone is ready, but I did want to shout out just the hashtags there below each team. If you retweet at OWX League with the hashtag Team Civ or Team Jockey, you'll be entered to win a controller skin from our sponsor Casual Gamer. I know you've seen those throughout the stream. It's been a really solid asset to the league throughout season 2, and we hope to continue that partnership. So get onto Twitter, retweet us, and have an opportunity to win. But I'm gonna check with the captains. We'll see if they're ready to start this next game again. Going to Volskaya, so we'll see what they have for us.
I'm actually enjoying my controller skin. I did win it from the Lucio Wall tournament that we hosted a while back.
SNK, you just can't stop winning. Didn't you? Weren't you on that season 1 team that won? And the season 2 team?
Yeah.
Season 1 team, season 2 team. The only thing he hasn't won is the 1v1, but I could absolutely see him winning that too. So, just absolutely crazy.
Wait.
It's a beast.
The 1v1?
This man is a beast.
Yeah. We had that 1v1 a few. Actually, that is interesting to note. Dirty Jockey and Civ met up in the, I believe, the semifinals of the 1v1 tournament. So, maybe a little bit of a revenge game happening there as well.
A little bit.
Maybe a little bit.
Yeah, he was seeking Savuki's blood, if you ask me.
Like every time from the first map of Oasis, I seen the kill feed, Dirty Jockey just killed Civ, and he was done. That was his job.
It's understandable. Whenever you take out what you believe is the biggest threat on the opponent's team, that's what you do. If the biggest threat is a Mercy that can keep everybody alive, you take them out first. If it's a nasty DPS such as Savuki, you take him out first. So I think he was definitely doing his job.
Yeah, I think you're right. Now on to Sky Industries.
Krause back on the D.Va.
Well, like Vivo was saying, that second point can be a little difficult to take sometimes, kind of depending on you know, when it could come in and how well the defense is setting up. So for me, I like Junkrat because the chokes are so tight on these types of maps, especially in the A point. I think Orisa you could always go and use. And I tend to see a lot of Pharah on Volskaya, maybe not as much in the second section, but we'll see if we have any Pharah players in here that want to try that out.
Also love to see a Hog, either on attack and defense, to pull people across the choke for easy picks.
Oh yeah, absolutely. You think about the TCPs like Hanamura, good opportunities for that as well. People saw that in the free agent scrims. You know, this past week, a lot of good Roadhog play.
Moira is actually really strong at this map too, because a lot of tight chokes, so you can just spam your damage orb through it. And Voskaya is a very boxy map, right? So the first point, second point, they are like square, so like you can bounce your orbs all over the place. And usually like Symmetra, like we're seeing right here, the damage orb just destroys them immediately, so it's really easy to clean up a car wash from Symmetra using Moira.
Absolutely. We have Dirty Jockey playing that Tracer, Firing Wolf playing the Mercy, Gel Capital playing the Symmetra, Parallax playing that Zarya, Third Eye Funkboy again playing that Reinhardt and Rayquaza, playing that Bastion. I like seeing a Bastion. He is kind of trickling in here at the end, but it doesn't look like it's going to be too detrimental to his team. We have Savuki back on that nasty McCree of his. Kyle Gunner on the D.Va that we all know and love from him. Just Buck playing that Lucio. Time Lord Prime playing a Reaper. Don Jiggy playing the Mercy and Psychrob back on that Reinhardt.
Yeah, what we saw on that first push, we had Kyle Gunner, Psychrob rather, on the Reinhardt on stream, and just kind of went into through the choke there, charged through, and was swinging really big, getting a lot of damage in, able to stay healed by the Don Jiggy pullback, tried to charge in again, and then went down. And once that shield went down, the entire attack had a really difficult time, kind of contested with a lot of the damage coming through and started falling. So we'll see if they regroup here and come back in. I think Psychrob staying up with the shield tank especially will be essential to them getting through the choke.
This is going to be very interesting. We do see Savuki playing that Junkrat, a character that he really hates to face, but does really enjoy playing. Dirty Jockey trying to do the best that he can to farm their spawn point, but Savuki switching over to that Junkrat to try and get more damage in through that choke. That seems to be a problem right now, and they're doing a pretty good job. Rayquaza able to take out that charging Reinhardt. Big smash coming in by Psychrob, and lots of action happening here at that choke. And it looks like Dirty Jockey's team, Firing Wolf, does res Rayquaza and Third Eye Funk Boy. Time Lord Prime taking out that Zarya on that Reaper. Dirty Jockey taking out Don Jiggy on that Mercy. Oh my goodness, so many things happening. I can't sum it up enough, and whew, I'm exhausted, boys.
Yeah, I think the artist had to earn a little bit of percentage. They will take that tick there, and the Bastion is a little bit too difficult to contend with for them at the time. But now he does go down, and they're starting to earn a little bit of percentage. Parallax getting pushed back here, and it does look like the attack will be able to take this. I think, it does look like... Now they're still trying to contest here, but I don't know if they'll have a lot of room to work with. Time where they're using the Death Blossom, but then gets taken down. Fire Emblem the only one there remaining, trying to get a res off, but not a lot of room to work with. Rayquaza coming back on the Bastion, but without a shield tank, I doubt he'll stay up for very long. They may just be staggering at this point. His Third Eye, again, in by himself, about to get focused down, and that will be a cap here for Civ's team in this next section.
My goodness, Savuki just doing some damage as that Junkrat. Kyle Gunner showing off, flexing on Dirty Jockey's team as D.Va, just doing a wonderful job. And then a big, big sound barrier coming in by Just Buck. And they're looking to capture this point very, very early. Lots of things happening on the point right now. And we do have Time Lord Prime playing that Pharah, throwing in some damage.
Yeah, really aggressive push coming directly and trying to get the kills they need. Gel Capital does fall on Moira, and that's a support down for the currently defending team. I'm not sure what Fire and Wolf is, but now they start to clean up their kills a little bit and wrap up that first fight. It was a good push there for Team Civ. No ults to work with now as Time Lord switches to Soldier. Kyle Gunner will have a D.Va ult here shortly, but Parallax with a grab could make this next attack difficult for them. The Shatter and the Valkyrie from Fire and Wolf over the horizon as well.
Absolutely. Third Eye Funk Boy just doing a phenomenal job as that Reinhardt to keep his team alive and just swinging that hammer as big as he can. As you can see, Dirty Jockey's just going to be floating around this map trying to find those picks and take out Savuki's team whenever he does see them. I can feel it. He's looking for that Mercy, and he does try and take her out, but unable to. Looks like Psychrob on that Reinhardt. They're all playing at that choke. We do have a few ults on Savuki's team, and there goes one. followed by two with a Riptire. Savuki taking out Dirty Jockey and Parallel Axe on that Tracer and that Zarya, but a big res coming in by Fire and Wolf, doing a wonderful job on the Mercy, pulling Dirty Jockey and Parallel Axe back up, and they are able to clean up this attack. Lots of things happening on the choke or on the point right now, and I do believe that Dirty Jockey's team will successfully defend this.
Yeah, that was a really big push there from Sif's team. Held well and still have ults to work with, and a couple on the way there for Team Jockey. Sitting in a good position, you know, a lot of time to contest with, though, 3 minutes and 40 seconds on the clock for Sif's team. Got time to scale it back and regroup. See Cal Gunner switching to the Roadhog off D.Va, and seeing if that may be the answer to unlocking this Team Jockey defense. But again, with Rayquaza about 20% away from the fourth ult for Team Jockey, it'll have to be a pretty economical push here for Sif if they want to find any success.
Yeah, they have to do a dry push right now, otherwise they don't have any ults to pretty much they only have the Earth Shatter right now. They have a sound barrier coming, but better to do a dry push.
I do agree with that. Trying to force out some ults, maybe, and level the playing field.
Yeah.
I'm sure they've been keeping track of those ults. Dirty Jockey looks like did use a pulse bomb there, but we'll be able to run that back very quickly. Breakaway still about 10% away from that Deadeye, and Sif's team hasn't quite engaged yet, so they've got time to continue earning that. They do have the sound barrier from Just Debug on its way. Don Chiki will be pretty close to a Valkyrie about the same time Savuki gets that Riptire. So it could be in for a pretty good fight here. It'll be more about ult economy than making sure you don't commit everything all at one time. You have some to fight another day.
Yeah, no doubt. As you can see, Dirty Jockey's team does have three ults. They're working on the fourth and fifth, while Savuki's team does have four and five coming up. So if it was to me, Savuki's team should be winning this next team fight. They do need to regroup and make sure that nobody gets picked, and that's going to be incredibly important for that team. But they do need to keep an eye out for Dirty Jockey. I do see Kyle Gunner playing that Roadhog. If he can hook that Tracer, kill Dirty Jockey as Tracer, and then they could all move in as a cohesive unit, I think they do a wonderful job and take that point back. Or
yeah, I agree. You see Dirty Jockey just causing problems in the back, just being a distraction, very difficult to find. But finally does hook him there and gets the hook. That's as I say that. The sound barrier will help. And that attack coming in, three down already, as Serdai and Fire will follow Dirty Jockey to the grave. So he does fall there. We'll see if Donji can use the Valkyrie to get him back up, keep this attack going. Gale Capital falls. It's just a very good push for Team Silver now.
Ooh, very nice job by Kyle Gunner to take out that Tracer like we were just discussing. And they are cleaning up. Firing Wolf again does res two of his teammates, Rayquaza and Guild Capital, on the support. Dirty Jockey coming back out, says no to Kyle Gunner, doesn't take him out. Don Jiggy picking Kyle Gunner back up. Savuki taking out Rayquaza, and lots of action happening here on the point. They should be able to take this team fight, but it does look like Third Eye Funk Boy taking out that effective Lucio, and Parallax on the Roadhog taking out Psych Raw. Lots of things happening. Kyle Gunner taking out Third Eye Funk Boy, and Parallax taking out Kyle Gunner. So lots of answers happening here. Time Lord Prime trying to track down that Mercy, but unable to, as Dirty Jockey does clean him up. And Dirty Jockey's team doing a great job defending this point. My goodness, I'm quite surprised Savuki's team has not done a better job of going in and, as one whole team, able to wipe them out. But Firing Wolf, he's my MVP right now. Firing Wolf is just doing a fantastic job on Mercy, keeping his team alive.
When you took the words out of my mouth, coming in with Mercy and getting the res on the two there just to keep that stall alive, knowing they have the short respawn to be able to continue contesting. Now down to 37%, they did give up a little bit over half a point, but they've at least got some room to work with. Sif's team came in very aggressively, and I thought they'd be able to take that the point pretty easily. But yeah, just doing well to keep the team alive.
No doubt. If we were to look at ult economy, Dirty Jockey's team does have four ults, to Savuki's team at two, three ults now. Parallelax doing a nice job with that Roadhog, Whole Hoggle coming out, taking out Kyle Gunner. So it is now a 5v6 on the point, and Savuki's team does need to make some big picks if they want to think about getting on the point and taking it.
Now the sound barrier coming out from Justy Buck in overtime here, trying to continue to keep the team alive as they go into finish this fight. But now Dirty Jockey in the back, just getting kills in the feed, picking up a double there on Cycron Time Lord. Overtime meter will be down, and a pulse bomb just for good measure. But 53.4% earned for Civ's team, something they can really take away. It's a good push there, but Dirty Jockey and his team have an opportunity to take, or rather tie up the series, and get a full push here.
Great job by Dirty Jockey's team defending that point. They did have a lot of time on the board to defend that. SNK, Pivo, what did you boys see?
Man, that was a lot of healing for the last point. Like, Moira and Mercy, you people never die. I think you have, 120 healing per second if you just use the Moira Orb, the Moira Spray, and then the regular Mercy Beam. It's, insane. And they both got their support ults consecutive team fights. So Valkyrie and Coalescence, which is, Moira Kamehameha. But they both did a really good job at the second point.
Yeah, I was impressed.
Focused on what they were trying to do. This team was not pushing at correct times. They should have used a B drop and then pushed in to begin the fight. They didn't use a B drop until they were actually on point.
So. Yeah, I would agree with that. I think they should have done a better job initiating, but here they are on the defense. This one kind of makes me chuckle a little bit because we've got a very ill team or defense that's coming with Savuki on that Bastion, Kyle Gunner playing that Orisa, Just Buck playing a Torbjorn, Time Lord Prime, and seeing him on some Sombra, he is an absolute flex. I play with him quite often, and it's nice to see him on another type of hero. Don Jiggy playing that Mercy and Psycra on that D.Va. Dirty Jockey again playing his namesake of Tracer, excuse me. He Firing Wolf back on that Mercy. Gil Capital on that Moira. Parallelax playing that Roadhog. Third Eye Funk Boy again playing that Reinhardt. And Ray playing that McCree. So if I had to guess one thing, it's going to be Dirty Jockey is going to be after that Bastion. And he is going to be after that turret being placed by Just Buck. And Just Buck does get taken out by Dirty Jockey. And Dirty Jockey does take out his turret as well. Kyra Gunner doing the best that he can to defend the point on the right-hand side, but Parallelax and Firing Wolf going around on the left-hand side, and they are just pushing in on this point hard. Dirty Jockey is seeking blood right now, just cleaning up. Takes out Don Jiggy on that Mercy. Parallelax cleaning up Kyle Gunner on that Orisa. You know, that Bastion Torb combo just didn't work out for them.
Yeah, and Dirty Jockey just running right in the back here. As soon as you said that he was going for that Bastion turret, it's instantaneous. Went for that, took out Time Lord Zuki in the back there on the Bastion, and it was just, you know, after that, they just started losing people left and right, could not stay alive, and that point was taken very, very quickly. Now with would be 6 minutes and 42 seconds coming into the second point. They're in a really good position here as Dirty Jockey picks up a kill on Don Jiggy, and now with two down, Civ's team is at a very difficult spot coming back into point. But now Civ switching to Tracer takes down Dirty Jockey, and puts his foot down and says, I'm not about to keep this, let this keep going.
Yeah, very nice shot by Civ to take out Dirty Jockey, but not to be no, or not to, I can't use my words right now, but Kyle Gunner did pull in Dirty Jockey on that Tracer, so that was very important for Civ to take Tracer out there as well. And we've got it, a Moira Coalescence coming in by Geld Capital and a big ult from Parallelax. They're pushing this point very hard. Savuki's team does need to get back on the point. There's lots of action happening right now. Third Eye Funk Boy just swinging big as that Reinhardt. And of course, Firing Wolf just keeping his team alive and giving them that extra damage boost, doing a wonderful job on that Mercy. And if Savuki's team does not get back, there's no way that they can win this team fight.
I like the supercharger here used by Kyle Gunner trying to keep everybody alive, but we'll get pulse from behind. The supercharger goes down as well, and Kyle Gunner there falls shortly thereafter. Final Wolf trying to keep the team alive as much as possible as they continue this push, but yeah, just an aggressive attack from Jockey right now. And I'm surprised the Civ's team has lasted as long as they have.
Yeah, absolutely, but Savuki's team is answering, taking out Parallelax, Time Warlord Prime, playing that Junkrat, doing a nice job on that tire. I can't believe my eyes. Fantastic job by Savuki's team to hold that point. My goodness gracious, if Savuki was not on that Tracer and contesting that point as long as he did, there was absolutely no way that they were going to fully defend this point. So nice job by Savuki's team. Time Lord Prime, oh my goodness, on that Junkrat. Fantastic job as well.
I think an essential switch for them, Civ going to the Tracer to try and keep Dirty Jockey at bay, and the Time Lord switching over and just showing how much these players can flex, and sometimes getting locked into certain roles throughout the season, getting to switch it up a little bit here in the All-Star game is fun to see. But now the attack coming back in for Dirty Jockey's team, just the one ult from Rayquaza to work with. Not a lot to follow a Dirty Jockey weapon at the pulse bomb. He's used those pretty effectively throughout the game, but again, just a strong defense from Team Civ so far. We'll see if they can continue about 4.5 minutes to go.
No doubt Rayquaz coming from behind at High Noon, but oh my goodness, Psychraw does eat up Rayquaz's High Noon ult. Very nice job by Psychraw. He does throw out that Diva Bomb, but unfortunately does not catch anybody. Lots of action happening on the point. Kyle Gunner taking out Fiery Wolf. Huge pick, if you ask me. Just Buck also taking out Rayquaz. And Geld Capital taking out Psychraw's Diva Mech. But Dirty Jockey doing a nice job cleaning everyone up. Does take out Don Jiggy. Savuki taking out Third Eye Funk Boy. And Savuki also taking out Parallel Axe. Lots of action happening on this point. And they're going to need to, this is a 2v2 battle. Now it's 1v1 Time Lord Prime versus Dirty Jockey. And let's see who takes this this team fight out.
Looks like this one maybe Dirty Jockey retreating a little bit, trying to give a little bit of help. And that's the entire team to contend with. But again, yeah, it's just causing problems in the back. They don't really have too much of an answer for him if Civ's not there.
No doubt.
Firewolf did waste a Valkyrie in that fight. During the retreat of Dirty Jockey.
Yeah, I kind of thought so too. I'm glad that you just brought that up. Fighting Wolf has done such a phenomenal job so far on that Mercy. That could have been his one misplay that we've seen so far, but they do have plenty of time, 3 minutes and 20 seconds to capture this. And a big slam coming in by Kyle Gunner. Fat Shatter, just as Pivo just said, and a followed up by a Lucio Sound Barrier, and they should be cleaning up this team fight without a problem.
Now getting an opportunity to see Civ coming back in and clean up as well. Does have a pulse bomb. They were able to deal with that attack pretty well. And just a huge shot of there. Do this from was that Kyle Gunner.
Yeah, Kyle Gunner.
To stop that attack in its tracks.
Absolutely. We do see Savuki does have his pulse bomb here. Let's see what he'll do with it. And Time Lord Prime, of course, is on fire. My man and Don Jiggy is coming up with that Mercy ult. So we'll see that Mercy ult, two ults on Savuki's team to the one ult of Dirty Jockey's team.
Oh, look at that sneaky McCree coming through the right. Oh, I thought he was going to go all the way, but a Dirty Jockey was in the back line all this time.
Ooh, that Dirty Jockey does take out Savuki and does take out Don Jiggy. Huge picks happening right now. Let's see if they can push this point a little bit better than what they had done beforehand. Third Eye Funk Boy taking out Kyle Gutter, but a big Rip Tire coming in from Time Lord Prime, taking out that essential Mercy and Parallel X. Time Lord Prime also taking out Rayquaz, and Savuki saying no on Dirty Jockey and taking him out as well. Great cleanup by Savuki as well on that Third Eye Funk Boy, and again Savuki's team is able to hold that point. I am incredibly impressed. Lots of high level gameplay from both of these teams. This is super exciting, guys.
Well, and Civ's team looked like they were dropping like flies there and would be in a really difficult spot, but that double tire there from Time Lord just really essential in helping them swing the tide of that fight, that having a short respawn, just helping them get back to point and continue defending. And now with a minute 30, it starts feeling a little bit of dicier for Team Jockey. They've got a couple ults they can use and try and combine well. They've got a few more on the way. Gale Capital's coalescence comes to mind here in the next fight or so, but they have a really good defense between themselves so far.
I'd like to see Psychraw keep that defense matrix up a little bit more whenever Dirty Jockey does throw those pulse bombs out. He's been doing a nice job getting those pulse bombs as quick as he can. And Savuki's team does need to try to get together a little bit right now. They're a little bit spread out on this map with Dirty Jockey's team on the right side. And a big shatter coming in from Kyle Gunner. Kyle Gunner taking that essential Firing Wolf on that Mercy out, taking out Rayquaz on that McCree. Huge shatter by Kyle Gunner, and a very nice defense being shown by Savuki's team.
Yeah, and again, just using those ults really smartly. He actually got in that shatter. It was the opposing Reinhardt, Third Eye Funk Boy, and Firing Wolf. Went directly for Firing Wolf, completely passing by Third Eye, just trusting this team to take him down, just going for that priority Mercy. And again, yeah, this defense really strong from them. 30 seconds left on the clock for Dirty Jockey's team. They've got a few ults to work with. They don't want to rush this too quickly, but they do have an opportunity to come back in and really make this last fight interesting.
Yeah, I started to see Savuki's team overextend a little bit, but they were cognizant and they decided to pull back onto the objective point. Now we've got Kyle Gunner charging in almost blindly as that Reinhardt. Hopefully he doesn't pay a price for that. And another Riptire coming out by Time Lord Prime. Where's this Riptire going?
On the grab coming in from Parallax, looking to grab a couple. Time Lord does grab two, Parallax and Dirty Jockey, but now it looks like the fight kind of all over the place, not necessarily on the point of Civ and Justy Buck trying to continue this defense as Third Eye Funk Boy comes in. Help with the Valkyrie coming in from Fire Wolf just to keep everybody alive.
Big shatter, nobody's taking out Fire Wolf. They need to take out that Mercy. That Mercy is so essential. But Don Jiggy coming in, taking it, bringing in Time Lord Prime. Time Lord Prime does get farmed pretty quickly. Kyle Gunner takes out Fire and Wolf. They may be able to contest this point for a little bit longer, and they may be able to hold this, but Gale Capital comes out with that Coalescence from Moira, and so much happening on the point. Savuki trying to stay alive, but he can't. He gets picked off by Dirty Jockey, and we are pixels away from Dirty Jockey's team taking this point, and they do. Dirty Jockey's team.
Get in.
Holy smokes, boys. Whew. I'm exhausted. What a match.
That was fantastic. Just a really good push there from Team Jockey there at the end, and I can't imagine how Donjiki didn't get on that with the res. So close, and just inches, like you said, pixels away from being able to contest that point.
So I Parallax died every single time for the Time Lord Riptire, so that feels bad, man. Did that for every single one of them.
Wow, as you can see, 55 eliminations coming in from Dirty Jockey. 30 objective kills, 44 eliminations coming in from Geld Capital. But in my opinion, the MVP is Firing Wolf. Firing Wolf did not get the votes, but his Mercy play sans that one, what I thought was sort of not, it was a little bit out of his playstyle or character. He was absolutely critical to Dirty Jockey's team, and he just did a phenomenal job keeping his team.
Sorry about that. I think I actually cut you off right there as we were going to intermission. But just continue what you were saying.
Oh, I was just kind of curious. We're two maps down. A lot of action happening right now. Who's everybody's MVP? We've got Team Civ. They've got one win. Team Jockey. They've also got one win. So it's 1v1 halfway through. Who's our MVPs, boys? So far.
So far, MVPs, huh? Well, I mean, I think. For it's got to be a few, right? Because Time Lord and Savuki is showing their ability to flex to a few different heroes and be able to answer to Dirty Jockey causing problems on Tracer. So I think they've really got to be right up there for me. But then, like you said, Firing Wolf just keeping the team alive, doing well to just hit those Valkyries at the right time. I think maybe we did mention had one wasted in that game, but overall just able to keep. I do a really good job of keeping everybody on their feet, and then Dirty Jockey again just causing problems and single-handedly kind of putting the team on his back a little bit to get some of those kills to finish up those fights. That's kind of it for me so far.
Absolutely. And Pivo, who's your halfway point MVPs at this time?
So from Civ's team, it might sound very biased and cheeky, but I'm going to give it to Time Lord because he was flexing a lot for all the games, and especially this last one when he switched to Junkrat, he just stayed on that top left high ground there, just raining bombs and then the Riptires. He was a nuisance, man, to that team. And then he was uncontested there, so he got his tires really quick. And overall, just a great job. And for a Team Jockey, I'll say Firing Wolf. Like, his Mercy play was fantastic. And it was impressive that he got his Valkyrie twice in a row when you have a Moira on the team, because they are both, like, really strong healers, and then you're competing by that, like, low HP. Really hard to get Mercy's ultimate as fast now if you have you're playing with Moira, but they both got it absurdly fast too.
No doubt. SNK, who are you saying?
On the side of Civ's team, I would say either Time Lord or Kyle. Kyle, he's been really great as tank.
Yes, he has.
He's been able to shield his team. He's been able to get picks when he needs to. His shatters are fat most of the times. Time Lord, he's been able to clutch on defense almost every single time. Or he was able to clutch multiple times on defense. On the side of Team Jockey, Wolf, he was able to keep his team alive most of those fights. Whenever Civ's team did get two picks, he was there to res them both. With Valkyrie. Also, Sarge, he was playing really, really, really great. Moira, he knew when to get out. Or no, I'm sorry, it wasn't Sarge. It was Geld. I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. He knew when to get out. He knew when to be in the fight. Just exceptional play.
Lots of great play all around. That is because this is the all-star game for the OWX League. I think we've got the third map coming up. Is that correct, Sultan? And what do you got for us?
That is correct. And we're actually going to Eichenwald. So switching off the 2CP to another hybrid, following up with Junkertown will be the last map. And then, well, actually, if it's still tied up 2-2, we'll go to a fifth control point map. But yeah, right now, just going to Eichenwald. And got a few substitutions happening as well. Sarge coming in for, I think that's Parallax for Jockey's team there. So we'll see if any substitutions come in for Civ's team and get this started.
No doubt. Sultan, of course, this is the All-Star game, which does conclude the previous season. But if I'm not mistaken, is there another season coming up soon? Is there a season that people can sign up for, maybe, perhaps? We can get this going?
Yeah, I know we're excited. Season 3 actually will start on January the 1st. The draft will be coming up in the next couple weeks over the Christmas holiday. So make sure that if you are not on the free agent list, you get to it. You can sign up on the website, owxleague.com/join. And get your name on that free agent list. We've got scrims going on here periodically as well to get exposure for you, get on the stream and captaincy. We have in store who you play and kind of where you may fit into their team. So make sure you get that done. And yeah, just excited for it. Season 3, man. Season 2 has been a blast.
Looking for a repeat here.
No. I was going to say, I just heard that Beats by Lucio is the best team.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, I hear that. People talk, right? You can hear the whispers in the wind.
Might be a little biased. We did lose in the final, but
yeah,
neither here nor there.
No doubt. So Season 3, you just said, is coming up. Seems like Season 3 will be starting January 1st to ring in the 2018 New Year. Very exciting. Which means that the OWX League is about 1 year old. I know I joined it at season one. It's been quite the ride, and I've really enjoyed my time here. So we just want to keep that energy and that flow coming up, guys and gals out there. Been a lot of fun, and the draft signups are coming up. They're happening right now. So we do have a draft system in the OWX League for season 3. Put your name in a pool. We're going to be having several captains. They will draft you just like it is the NFL, the MLB, the NBA, etc. So showcase your talents by the scrims that Sultan had mentioned, and let's kick off season 3 with a bang.
Mm-hmm. Wow, it's 1 year old, the league, already?
It is 1 year old, yep.
Wow.
Pretty awesome, huh?
Man, time flies, dude. Like, it's I thought it was like only 6 months because I joined. It was over the summer, right?
I believe so.
That was the beginning of season 2 there in the summer. But first season was kind of end of January, February, I believe.
Yep.
You can actually see some of those old games from season 1 on our YouTube channel. It's a link on the website, owxleague.com, or just search for Overwatch X League on YouTube.
Yeah.
No doubt. I mean, this
league has the best team names, like Beats by Lucio again, Hard Zenyatta's, it's fantastic. Zaya Kidding Me. Those are great.
Overwatch Divas. Names.
Overwatch Divas.
I actually missed my name.
Lots of great puns, for sure.
Yeah, season 1 teams had some pretty solid names, so it was a lot of fun. But I think everyone is ready to go. We got a few substitutions. Pierpain 420 coming in for Time Lord. Kind of a like-for-like DPS. They both play a lot of flex characters, so I think Pierpain coming in could make it interesting for Civ's team. And Greatish and M coming back in for Rayquazix. So a couple changes. We'll see if both teams are ready. Looks like we do have readies from both captains, so get going to Eichenwald.
Pierpain straight from Minnesota in the cold right now. With mittens playing Overwatch.
Nice. Probably.
Oh my god.
I'm in Texas. Man, it's been in the 60s right now.
If it's cold in Virginia, like, imagine freaking Minnesota.
Well, I'm raging. You're in California.
California.
down here in Texas.
Ooh, Texas. San Antonio, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Central Texas. Nice stuff, my man. All right. And we go to Eichenwald for the third map out of four. This is your hybrid map. Capture the point, push the payload to the final objective. And I imagine we're going to see, again, Dirty Jockey on that tracer. But there should be a few different changes that I see already. And this could be pretty exciting, boys. Pretty exciting indeed.
Yeah, immediately, Pure Pain 420 coming in on the tracer. Kyle Gunner once again going D.Va, Bo Billy coming back in as Mercy. For the attackers, it's like Dirty Jockey now switching to Genji. Or rather, Tracer, sorry. Firing Wolf on Genji, Guild Capital going Mercy Sarge on Winston, Third Eye Funk Boy on Zarya, Greatest Shinem on Lucio. The defenders rounding out Cyclops, picking up Junkrat. Justy Buck going Lucio and Civ. Looks like he'll be going Roadhog.
Oh, a Roadhog from Savuki. I like it. I like it a lot. But we do see Firing Wolf on that Genji. Pretty interesting, if you ask me. Should be pretty cool.
I like the new dive composition from Dirty Jockey's team to try to get to the point quicker. Like the new dive, right? They now you swap Zenyatta for the Mercy.
Yep.
Because you know you have you need a Mercy now. She's like very very strong.
She is very strong. I do agree.
It does feel like Mercy's got an auto lock in this meta, just with the res. It's just too valuable not to have them, especially when you're facing a team with a Mercy. And then obviously the healing and the damage coming from the Valkyrie just growing exponentially.
No doubt. And we have Kyle Gunner throwing out some D.Va rockets on the opposing team. But Sarge trying to jump in as Winston and unfortunately does not land exactly where he wanted to. But that's okay because he does do it the second time. Throws down that Winston bubble and is able to start harassing Bo Bidley on that Mercy and Kyle Gunner in that D.Va. So lots of action already happening at the choke. Pretty exciting if you ask me, because a lot of teams like to hold that choke down as long as they possibly can. Savuki getting that huge pick on Third Eye Funk Boy, but Dirty Jockey taking out Bo Bidley on that Mercy. So Dirty Jockey again doing what he's been doing, and that is taking out the support characters for Savuki's team.
And the defense holding well here. The attack still relatively grouped up, actually. I think it's why they've lasted as long as they have. The healing coming in from Geld Capital has been extraordinary. And while the defenders still have the strength in the point, it's still definitely a pretty solid initial attack for the attackers. They're kind of continuing to come, I wouldn't say staggering back in per se. They do have a short respawn, but they don't really have, I think, the numbers to overtake altogether. But I guess as long as they're fighting on the point and away from the choke, it's kind of a positive for them. Self-destruct now coming in, does connect there. Third at Funk Boy, the victim to that self-destruct, Bo Billy then falling though for the defense. That may be the initiation of the attack. These Team Jockey coming in looking for an opportunity to gain a little bit of sticking percentage on this point. The defense not making it easy for them. Kills going back either side as Sif, Fire Wolf, and Cyclops just swapping back and forth in the feed. Holes favor the attack, however, as they have a couple to work with here. A few on the defense as well, but they haven't decided to use them just yet. And Dirty Jockey picking up a double there, rather just taking Kyle Gunner out of mech, picking up the pilot, trying to continue the third at Funk Boy's Graviton will come in, see if they can bind with anybody, and that is a nice pulse bomb there on Pure Pain from Dirty Jockey. Picks up Justy Buck as well, and I think the attack actually may be able to do something with this.
No doubt. Savuki dancing as best as he can on the point as that Roadhog. He's going to try and stay alive. He does go whole hog on the opposing team, but it looks like he's taking some damage, and he does go down by Dirty Jockey, of course, because we know Dirty Jockey is seeking after Savuki.
Yeah, and nice job by Dirty Jockey. Of course, come back in and try and keep this contest alive. They've lost a tick now, so a little bit on the back foot, but now Fire Wolf coming in, looking for a little bit with Dragon Blade. Is able to find Bo Bidley before that Sound Barrier comes in to help keep him solving the point. That's, I don't think, will be a successful ult if you're Firing Wolf still able to take down Bo Billy, who has been crucial to keeping the defenders alive, but now really starting to earn some serious percentage. I think they will be able to cap this first point.
No doubt. I did see Just Buck use his Lucio ult. I would have liked to have seen him kind of conserve that a little bit for these next team fights. I thought that fight was pretty much over for a while there, but you know, I can understand why he was trying to contest that, because Savuki's team has just done a wonderful job contesting points and getting back there as soon as possible. But now we have Dirty Jockey's team on that payload. They're going to be pushing it as far as they possibly can. And there's a lot of action happening right now at that choke. Savuki just spamming in that Roadhog damage, and a big D.Va bomb going in and doesn't catch anybody. Unfortunately, unfortunate for Kyle Gunner 01. Nice job by Dirty Jockey's team by staying alive and keeping that payload pushed down the road. And they're just kind of just moving along pretty well.
Yeah, beautifully placed Diva Bomb there from Kyle Gunner, but I think the defenders or attackers rather just privy to it and able to get out of the way. But maybe helping zone them out a little bit and get this defense up to this first corner, easier to hold here, then a little bit further back with some more open. And you see a lot of the defense. A lot of defense on this point, stay at this corner, trying to prevent the attack from getting too much after having taken the point.
No doubt, Pure Pain was able to take out that Mercy on Geld Capital, playing that Mercy. Very nice job by Pure Pain. It forced Dirty Jockey's team to move backwards, and they're doing a nice job staggering that team. And Pure Pain does take out Dirty Jockey. Very nice movement by Pure Pain himself, and a big hook and a Riptire coming in by Psychraw and taking out Gale Capital on that Mercy as well. So lots of picks happening by Savuki's team, but a big, big Zarya ult, but they don't really follow up. Nothing really happens. Firing Wolf does go Genji Blade, but doesn't really kill anybody except for just Buck. Third Eye Funk Boy killing Savuki after Savuki was going whole hog. And it looks like Dirty Jockey's team is going to be making a move on this payload. Savuki's team needs to retreat a little bit because Third Eye Funk Boy will be frying Kyle Gunner on that D.Va while he is playing that Zarya. Nice job by Dirty Jockey's team to sort of win that team fight, move on in. Just Buck needs to retreat as fast as he possibly can, but he does get picked off by Sard. Savuki's team has to pull back. They've got to pull back right now.
Man, Third Eye Funk Boy is lit. Like, he's supercharged right now.
Yeah, he's doing a phenomenal job on that Zarya, and that was a huge Graviton that they had there at that choke point that was able to allow them to win this team fight and move the payload down the road.
He's like one of those glow sticks from raves, like, you know, the one you crack.
What's really interesting is that's actually his main. He's a tank flex player, but he really likes Zarya the most out of every tank.
I believe it because he's doing a great job, and you can
see another crab.
Another crab on the point, doing a wonderful job. Dirty Jockey following up, getting that pulse bomb in, was able to clean up a couple of those kills, and we've got just a small contestion by Pure Pain on the Genji, but he does go down. Dirty Jockey's team able to get the payload to the big door here on Eichenwald.
Yeah, Pure Pain switching to the Genji just may be a matter of kind of going back and forth with Dirty Jockey, each on Tracer. But what I was going to say, it looks like Civ's team was a little, or rather, Jockey's team a little bit tentative with their push. They had about five or six ults and just really waiting for an invitation to come in and finally attack. It did, and they were able to push through that B section with a little bit of time left on the clock coming into this last little section here. So they'll have to be smart again about ults. Bo Billy, the only one on Civ's team with an ult. They've got a few on the way, able to use that Valkyr should things start to go a little south for them. But we'll have to be aware of Firing Wolf's Dragonblade, looking to get that in and get those supports out early.
No doubt, as you can see, Dirty Jockey's team, three of those teammates are on fire. They're doing a wonderful job, but a big Riptire coming in from Psychraw to get the greatest Gen M on Lucio. Kyle Gunner cleaning up Firing Wolf on that Genji, and Savuki taking out Dirty Jockey. As you know, he has a smile on his face after doing that.
And we got it on stream too. It's a really solid pull. He grabbed Dirty Jockey just aware of where that recall was going to be and anticipated it well, able to pick him up. But yeah, still looks like there's a lot of time to work with here for Team Jockey. They're going to rush this next point. We've got some ults they can start to build, and could be in a good position here if they're just smart about how to do this.
No doubt, Savuki's team has a little under a minute right now to defend this point. I think they can do it if they play this correctly. They do have three ults on their side, two Dirty Jockeys, none. And there's a couple huge ults coming in. Big smash coming in. Dirty Jockey does take out Bo Diddley, and Firing Wolf taking out Pure Pain. Oh my goodness gracious. That is a team kill by Dirty Jockey's team, and there is no way that they won't fully capture this point. That was an amazing job.
Fire Wolf did all resets. It was not even his ult. He just got reset dashes all over.
Very nice job. And a big Zarya Graviton coming in. Dirty Jockey cleaning up with another Pulse Bomb on Just Buck. Pure Pain taking out Guild Capital on that Mercy. And he also takes out Fire Wolf. Third Eye Funk Boy taking out Bo Diddley on the Moira. And lots of action happening on the point. And it looks like Dirty Jockey's team is going to push it in. They are able to capture that point with a little over 5 seconds, I believe, left on the map. Nice stuff by Dirty Jockey and company.
Yeah, nice to see from them being able to take that point with just a little bit of time left on the clock. That is going to help them should this go into a round three. But yeah, after like I said, a timid, kind of a timid push on the B section, able to come back and really get through that C section really quickly.
Yeah, I believe Civ should have, like, Civ's team should have switched to, like, a barrier tank earlier in the map, because they had, like, the Rohawk Zarya, and even though Rohawk can just tank a shit ton of damage, but he's an battery for the enemy team. So, like, if you have the barrier, that's a better way of, like, blocking damage coming in. And then they did switch at the end there, and they were able to stall. But I think they should have switched a little bit earlier.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. That D.Va was kind of a bad pick to go against Azaria.
Oh, yeah. But that was an impressive... next round, yeah. Yeah, it was impressive, like, that Firewolf just got all the kills with dashes. He was being damage boosted by the Mercy, but anyway, it was, like, really good. It was a really good play by him.
Attackers incoming in 30 seconds.
Let's see if Savuki's team can answer. I do see Pure Pain on that Pharah. I do like that Pharah pick a lot, because Pharah can be very, very sneaky going around the Eichenwald towers and able to sort of pick off Dirty Jockey's team from behind. So let's see if that's his game plan, or if he plans just going right over the top and saying, hello, I'm here and you're about to face my rockets.
It does have the pocket there from Bo Bidley. They've got Justy Buck and Reserve to heal the rest of the members coming in through the choke section there. We'll see if Pure Pain can get any damage in. Obviously, the early picks here could make this contest really easy for them, but wow, just immediately eliminated Dirty Jockey. Not even causing a problem.
Big pick. It's a huge pick.
Behind. It just takes him down so early, looking for the greatest gen. And he's able to get a second one. That's a second direct hit kill, and already two members down for the defense. Pure Pain running right here behind their back line, looking for another. His fireball, I believe, is low there on Mercy, getting a little bit of health back, but already the attack coming into the point, and they may be able to cap this very quickly if Team Jockey isn't able to stay on the field a bit longer.
Huge picks by Pure Pain. His tracking right now is next level. I have seen him hit so many direct hits, and he's just doing a wonderful job staying alive and harassing Dirty Jockey's team in the back line. They're really not accounting for him at all. He does not have that Mercy anymore, so he does need to make sure that he stays alive long enough to help the rest of his team out, and he does pull out from where he was. You can see him sort of going back and forth between he versus Dirty Jockey in the back, as well as Geld Capital. That is a 2v1 distracting Dirty Jockey's team, but unfortunately he does get picked off by that Tracer on Dirty Jockey. So nice job by Dirty Jockey to pick off Pure Pain, but I imagine that he's going to be coming back to harass them even further, because he's at 75% of his Rocket Barrage.
Yeah, and his he was kind of in a tough spot there, didn't have a healing, couldn't really get back to the rest of his team. But speaking of not having the Mercy, Firing Wolf is the reason why that point wasn't taken. Firing Wolf able to keep the team alive and stay away from Pure Pain Detroit, who got him pretty low on health a number of times, but able to get away, keep the rest of the team alive, and they wrapped up that defense pretty well, even though Pure Pain was causing some issues. But now Civ going in on Dirty Jockey, try to flank him from behind, and that could be the initiation that they need to push in here. Though they did lose just T-Bucks, they may want to wait here a little bit, but really may have enough healing to keep them going. But Pure Pain with a Rock Rush here could use this as an opportunity to get in Dirty Jockey out of commission.
Yeah, I'd like to see him couple this with Kyle Gunner's big Reinhardt smash, as well as potentially Savuki's High Noon that he has. And there goes the Rocket Barrage. Pure Pain coming in, does take out Greatest Gen, but Dirty Jockey does pick him off. Just Buck taking out Sarge, and Bo Diddley picking Pure Pain back up. Firing Wolf, of course, playing that Mercy, doing a wonderful job, picks up two of his teammates, and there's so much action happening on the point, I can't keep track of it all.
Yeah, both Valkyries coming out now just to keep these teams alive as this engagement goes down. Kyle Gunner able to take out Third Eye Funk Boy. Pure Pain adding another one on Greatest Gen. Civ getting in on the action as well. So his points start to tick up a little bit. They may be able to take this next tick here, but the defense still holding well, digging their heels and preventing them from getting any sticking damage. There, now they will take a point and maybe be able to wrap up this A capture with a little bit more time, I believe, than Team Jockey had. Maybe a little bit less, rather.
Yeah, no doubt. I think you're right. But I just got to say, Pure Pain doing a wonderful job on that Pharah, harassing the opposing team as best as he can, and he's just cleaning up. Nice job by Pure Pain. We've seen him play Tracer, we've seen him play Genji, now he's playing Pharah. As you can see, he is a flexible DPS.
Yeah, well, an interesting thing that happened was that Geld Capital put down his teleporter, but he put down way too, like, a little bit too far, so when their Jockey teams got wiped, they couldn't have They didn't have time to come back because his distance from the teleporter to the point was a little bit too big.
No doubt, pure pain. Now switching off that Pharah back to that Genji. I can imagine that he wants to harass that back line to take out Fire Wolf and Gale Capital, playing the support role on Dirty Jockey's team. And of course, you can see Dirty Jockey is on fire like he has been pretty much the whole time during this All-Star game. He's just a phenomenal tracer, and he's just doing a nice job for his team.
And again, doing his thing in the back, getting those kills. He kept quiet for a little bit there with pure pain causing him some issues, but able to come back in and get some kills again on fire here, and about 10% away from another pulse bomb that will definitely be helpful for them going to this next engagement.
No doubt, and you can see Savuki does have his ult still, Kaio Gunner as well, and there comes in a Graviton from Psychraw. They are able to take out one, two, three, take out most essentially Firing Wolf on that Mercy, and right now it's a 6v3 matchup. Dirty Jockey's team does need to pull back. They need to regroup, otherwise this could be over for them very quickly if they want to hold this point.
Yeah, and again, a really good push. They've got 2 minutes on the clock to try and get through this last section here. Civ does have a Deadeye, but it's pretty much the closest one. They'll really be able to use Valkyrie, but looking at ults on the other side, the defense has quite a few things they can use here to try and keep the attack at bay. The pulse bomb there from Dirty Jockey connects with Psychra, who gets res by Bo Biddley immediately, so that will be on cooldown, but it will be a little bit stronger. Bo Biddley now falling with Greatest Genem's tactical visor, and picks up a second on the other support just to debug, and Civ falls as well, and they may be able to hold right here and force Civ's team to just kind of regroup.
Interestingly enough, we just saw Sarge, he threw down his Orisa Bongo that did help them secure that win there, and then he jumped off the map. Very nice awareness by Sarge because he wanted to switch over to that Reinhardt. I commend him for that. That's great map awareness of what's happening with the other team respect to his team.
Yeah, and able to get back in time for the next fight. That's a pretty good switch from him, and using this respawn sweep advantage. But now getting pinned here by Kyle Gunner and put in a tough spot. But Kyle Gunner now in the back line does go down, and Justy Buck gets res there. Kyle Gunner does come in with a res as well as the Valkyrie goes off for Bo Biddley. Pure Pain now going into Dragon Blade. Ults coming out all over the place for each of these teams. But Team Civ able to clean up the kills that they need to push this into the last section. I believe we'll be able to cap this point pretty cleanly.
Yeah, huge, huge, huge Lucio sound barrier coming in by Just Buck. He was able to save his team, and he, in the process, was able to kill two of the defending teammates, or not teammates, opposition, two of the defending opposition. So doing a nice job, or a nice job by Just Buck on that Lucio.
Coming back in, we see Dirty Jockey with the pulse bomb looking again to get in the back and kind of tickle those back line supports a little bit. Not a lot of ults really in the field for anyone building here a little bit, so just maybe a little bit of poking and prodding around this corner here before they actually decide to engage. With a minute and 30 or so to work with, they've got a lot of time to kind of build up those ults and engage intelligently. Pure Pain the first falling here, so Team Jockey's defense may have a little bit of encouragement, and Team Civ may have to drop off just a little bit here and wait for their sixth member.
No doubt, Sarge doing a nice job just swinging with that hammer. And as you can see, Greatest Gen M does take out Savuki, and they do need to pull back, as just as you said. They're missing both their big damage or DPS players right now. And if they don't play this correctly, they're just going to start trickling, and there's no way they're going to win this point and carry it into overtime.
So now in a minute, they do have two ults they can use and a few more on the way. They may have six ults by the time, actually probably will have six ults by the time this next fight breaks out. And again, just about ult economy, we've seen them use quite a few ults all at the same time, so be smart about how they come
big
in.
Smash.
The first one comes in, the Shatter will get Sarge, as Civ wraps him up, and already a really good start for them. The Coalescence coming up from Gale Capital on Moira, just looking to keep the team alive and shred the rest of the opposition, but Kyle Gunner and Psychra combining well to get a good double, and now the Bogut, or rather Fire Emblem, is out of the fight. Could make it really difficult for them.
Huge!
Ult again coming out, Pure Pain with the Dragon Blade, Psychra grabbing a couple as well, Psychra adding another one. Bogut really does fall for the attack, but they're still coming in. They just need to take out Sarge, so we'll take out this last little section. Coming with the Contest, Fire Emblem switching to Lucio to try and keep this going as long as possible. Now Dirty Jockey trying to come in to stall as well. Ult's coming out again. The sound barrier from Justy Bug will keep the attack alive, but now the short spot bunch of Graviton will cause some problems for the attack. And I don't know if they'll be able to keep up this fence down. The rest of the defenders coming back in, and I don't know if Team Civil will have any time on the clock, even if they do cap the point.
Huge! There's so many things happening right now, I can't keep up. Oh my god, and then we have a Mercy ult happening right now on the point, and they are able to capture it. Oh my goodness, my heart is beating so fast for both of these teams. Savuki just popping off as that McCree. Lots of things happening with a big Zarya Graviton from the defense there. Huge. Lots of fun stuff happening, boys. Lots of fun stuff.
And the time is even, too. Like, they have the, pretty much the same amount of time. It's a five-second difference from the two teams.
Right, what a finish. Just the 5 seconds making the difference for Team Jockey, able to get in right before that overtime. But Civ's team answering back well and able to push in the final point there in overtime. It's not a minute for either one of these teams to settle it here. Tied up 1-1 in the series. And, yeah, don't go anywhere, folks. It's getting exciting.
Stupidity is not a right. Right beside you.
Man, there's so much action happening right now. SNK, what's your take, my man?
Good plays from both teams.
Championship take from you. Championship title.
I'm not a man of many words. That is not me. but my take of it is both teams are playing well. Dirty Jockey is playing well. Civ is trying to counter him as best as he can. But Dirty Jockey's just getting a lot of free looks. A lot of easy ult charge.
No doubt, lots of stuff happening by Dirty Jockey and the rest of his team. The rest of his team is also playing well. And Civ's team is also playing well. And that is because this is the all-star game, folks, for the OWX League. Right now, we are in overtime on Eichenwald. It is 3v3. Savuki's team, they are pushing in right now on the offense. They have 35 seconds left to capture this point before they hand it over to Dirty Jockey.
Well, not a lot of time to deliberate either. Already down to 30 seconds, looking for a way to come into the point, but nobody falling just yet. Kyle gone to the first casualty, and that will make this attack very difficult without that shield tank. The rest of his team coming in, mostly because they don't have too much of a choice otherwise, but Kyle Gunner, now Bo Billy falling as well, and that's that could make it a little bit difficult for them. Sarge now dropping pure, being able to answer one back, but again, the defense a little bit stronger. And so far, I don't know if the attack has the strength to be able to push off these defenders.
Yeah, Pure Pain doing the best that he can to stay alive and sort of contest this point. He does get it onto it just in time, but he gets picked off immediately, and so it does not count. Very nice defense by Dirty Jockey's team right there. Savuki's team not able to answer.
And it was a shame for Pure Pain, less than 10% away from the Dragon Blade. They really could have changed the tide had he been able to get it off. But now just a draw to play for Jockey's team now coming in on this attack. We just need that tick to get the win here.
Game on. One shot, one kill.
Jockey going with the Widow pick early to see if maybe that can change the tide of the fight very early.
Very interesting.
Getting picks early, especially with Widow, that honestly game-changing. You only need to win one fight, especially when you only need a tick. So we'll see if he's able to get that essential pick early. And if Team Civ is even anticipating this pick.
Yeah, no doubt. Pure Pain, he is playing that Genji again. Bo Billy on that Mercy. Psycraw on the D.Va. Just Buck on the Lucio. Kyle Gunner back on that Reinhardt. He's been playing Reinhardt very well since anytime that he is choosing that character. And Savuki this time, no longer on the McCree. He is on that Soldier. That Soldier could be very, very essential for that team. Lots of picks that could be happening.
So now as this attack comes in, not a lot of time to really swirl your thumbs at the choke there, looking to come in aggressively. Civ aware of maybe a flanker coming through, keeping an eye out for it, but the rest of the defense sitting a little bit further back, but not really letting the Widow there have a lot of room to work with. Though Dirty Jockey did switch to Tracer, so maybe not an issue for him to begin with. But now coming into the point, a little bit of contesting happening, nobody going down yet again. Obviously, we saw Kyle gonna go down early for the attack the last time, so they made it a little bit more difficult for them. But now it's third eye front boy falls. That may be the difference maker right there.
Yeah, absolutely. Huge pick. Third Eye Funk Boy just doing a great job. And Savuki also picks out Firing Wolf, but Dirty Jockey does take out Pure Pain. Psycraw taking out Greatest Gen M. Dirty Jockey taking out that Mercy. That Mercy pick could be absolutely enormous. But Savuki says, no, 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 not today. And he hits him with that Soldier Rocket. Very nice job by Savuki. And it looks like they're going to hold this point right now.
At Third Eye trying to contest as much as possible, maybe able to stall long enough for Fire Emblem to get to the point to keep this going. And two mobile characters here as the Raiders Shenham on Lucio trying to stall as long as possible.
Bad the Shatter, Shatter comes man.
In. Rogue Kyle Gunner catches Third Eye Funk Boy and will wipe him down. But the rest of the attack coming back in here as Gale Capital is able to pick up that res on Raiders Shenham, which could be helpful for them. The defense has a lot to work with here, but the attack is starting to fall, and I don't know if they'll have the numbers to keep this contest up.
No way. There's no way they can have the numbers. And as you can see, that's a big victory by Psychro with that D.Va ult and then the Lucio beat draw. And it is a draw on Eichenwald. Huge things happening there at the end, boys. Lots of fun. This is the All-Star game. Fantastic for the Overwatch League coming into Season 3.
Yeah, just honestly really impressive play. I was excited for this game and definitely just excited that we're getting to see these players play at this level, because that is just great game so far. Great games. Dirty Jockey once again just going off in the back. So yeah, we'll get the final map. I believe it will be Junkertown. Settle it for us here, and because this one was a draw, so no chance for a 2-2 tie. Go into the final map, and we'll see what they have ready for us. We'll be right back. So now coming into the final round here, the fourth round, will be on Junkertown after the draw on Eichenwald and everything to play for on the line. We'll see if any substitutions get made, but what do you guys see from this final match?
Go for it, Pivo.
Well, I expect the pirate ship comp to come out. It's a lot of fun to watch. It's not a fun to play against, but I like watching it because I love Bastion, so I don't know. Mm-hmm. I'm expecting it.
This is definitely... this is definitely a great Bastion for them. Yeah. Especially with Kyle Gunner and probably Psyche as tanks. I think they should be fine. On attack, at least.
Now, Payload is a lot of fun. It is the fourth map type that we have on Overwatch at this time. Sultan, what do you think about this? What's happening, my man? You having fun?
Oh, man, just so excited about the All-Star game, just in general, and like I said, couldn't have asked for a better game coming out, and getting the, just going back and forth, obviously Oasis was hugely competitive, and then Jockey's team coming back on Full Sky, getting that win going in and getting the draw on Eichenwald, now everything to play for here in the final round, bragging rights for the last game of the season, and I'm pumped, man, I'm excited.
Absolutely. We'll see what happens here, if there's any substitutions coming in for either team, and then off to Junkertown.
Trying to see if we do have any subs. A few people again waiting. We could see Time Lord come back in. Rayquaze also waiting. Don Jiggy over there as well. So we'll see what they have in store for us. But again, just to remind you guys, Season 3 does start on January the 1st. The draft signup is on the website, owxleague.com/join. Make sure you get onto that list and get into the draft so that these captains can pick you up for their teams. You can also get into the scrimmages. We'll have them every week. And actually, the next two are coming up on tomorrow and Tuesday. We'll have them. So make sure you're in the Discord and, again, link on the website to get there and get signed up for that so you can show off your ability and get picked up in the draft. That'll be in the next couple weeks, and you can get more information about that on the website or in the Discord, so make sure you're signed up there. Again, we are with the hashtags here, Team Jockey and Team Civ. Make sure you retweet us to have an opportunity to win a custom controller skin from Casual Gamer, and that's at OWXLeague. I don't do a lot of tweeting usually.
There's a lot of people out there that do a lot of tweeting.
Right?
Yeah.
Birds do a lot of tweeting.
I try and get into it. Maybe I'm just too old, man. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
I'm so funny, guys. So funny.
Birds do a lot of tweeting.
Nerd.
And
looks like
the real question is, so the real question is, if I tweeted, would I be eligible to win?
Probably. Yeah, that's an important question.
You're an admin. I don't think so.
I
think I'm eligible either.
Come on.
I am.
You think, right?
I am not an admin, so I should be eligible. So
you better be tweet.
That's true.
Yeah. I got it. My boy Time Lord. That he's gonna win. Again, no bias at all. But yeah, Jenkintown is a weird map. Like, talking about it, it's the map with a lot of really long side lines. So Widow is a really strong pick in that map. And usually when you see like pro play for this map, they just roll it until the last point because they do the Bastion, Risa, Mercy comp, right? And it's a really strong one, but it's sort of a glass cannon comp that if you pick one part apart, the whole thing just crumbles. So it's really hard to set up again. But as soon as it's set up, it just rolls the other team. So I'm excited to see what they're going to do.
Well, Junker me Town. Too. Looks like we are actually ready to start this game, though, as well. Sorry, what were you about to say, Reggie?
I was about to say, Junkertown is the most recent map that has been added to the console realm of Overwatch. Lots of fun. I like this map a lot. There's lots of tight corridors, so I can see a Moira being incredibly effective. I'd like to see another Junkrat coming out for his own map. He would be very effective on that as well.
Like Sol, you said that we are a little bit.
No doubt, and you said that we are about on our way. And stay tuned after this match, folks. We will crown the winner, and we also have a special announcement for the OWX League coming up.
Suspense. Do we have a drum roll, like the sound?
I don't think I have.
We can do
that's what I'm missing from the broadcast. Honestly, is the soundboard.
And then Raging makes all the sounds. So, like, we pre-record, like, Raging makes the sounds, and then it's your soundboard.
Yeah, perfect. I like it. I'm coming in on Junkertown. I'm already setting up the attack. Dirty Jockey, Genigo, and Tracer. He's played Tracer quite well throughout this game. Iron Wolf and Guild Capital grouping up as the supports again, Lucio and Mercy, respectively. Sarge going, Orisa. Third at Funk Boy, the second Shield Sync on Reinhardt, and Rayquaza is going the Bastion.
Well, see?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Hey, good call.
Rayquaza does have a decent amount of time as a Bastion, so it be interesting to see him play.
And for the other side, Civ again going the Junkrat, who we've seen him play a couple times in this game. Kyle Gunner now switching to Orisa, who I think has not played Orisa in this game so far, but definitely really solid Orisa. Justybuck going Reinhardt, Pure Pain on Bastion. Bo Bidley, Mercy, and Psychro going Ana.
No doubt. This is very interesting. We do see a Bastion versus Bastion here coming up, as long as Rayquaza is not trolling us. And Savuki on that Junkrat. I'm liking these picks right now. But let's see if Psychro can keep everyone alive on Ana. Ana is an incredibly powerful pick right now. Unfortunately, the console has been very tough to play her because the skill cap ceiling is so high. We do know that she'll be getting some changes coming up that'll help her out for everyone that likes to play Ana with a controller. So we'll see how that works out. But Dirty Jockey seeks and destroys that Mercy being played by Bo Diddley, but Pure Pain taking out Sarge very quickly, playing Bastion.
Yeah, and it's a little bit of a battle in the back here. Savuki seeing Dirty Jockey trying to come in from behind, kind of splitting his attention a little bit, trying to stay to the front as well. And Dirty Jockey's just been difficult to contend with, like he has been through this entire time. Firing Wolf, wolfing up Savuki from behind as this attack continues to push. And some of the defenders getting pushed back a little bit. Bo Bidley finally coming back after having fallen. Pure Pain back there on Bastion, but without a shield tank, finds a tough spot as Dirty Jockey picks him off with a pulse bomb. And then Dirty Jockey just cleaning up the supports. Just kind of too easy for him back there at the moment.
Holy smokes, Dirty Jockey just farming back there. He is just taking out everybody and anybody that he sees on his screen. It looks like his team is going to capture this first point pretty easily, and they do. They do have 5 minutes and 18-20 seconds, however you may want to read it as, to that next point for them to capture. And Savuki's team does need to pull back. They're getting picked one by one. Savuki just getting dismantled by Dirty Jockey there, as he is playing Junkrat. So yeah, let's see if they can sort of regroup, gain their composure back a little bit, and stop Dirty Jockey's team from advancing the payload so quickly.
Yeah, I do like the damage coming in from Savuki on Junkrat, but not able to do too much right now. And maybe a matter of switching up the heroes a little bit, seeing if there's a way to break through the shield defense that Team Jockey's running right now.
Absolutely, and a big smash coming in.
Yeah, and huge Rayquaza shadow just melted immediately, though.
Absolutely. Rayquaza just staying on top, staying as Bastion, just doing his thing, you know, Third Eye Funk Boy protecting him. You know, they're all just like, this is that pirate ship comp that Pivo was just talking about. It's not very fun to play against, but it sure is fun to play. You know, whenever you've got somebody just as strong as Dirty Jockey going out, seeking, destroying the other team, it makes it a lot easier for the rest of his team to clean up what he didn't kill. And as you see there, huge pulse bomb from Dirty Jockey coming in, picking up Kyle Gunner and Pure Pain, and then finishing off Just Buck. My goodness gracious, Dirty Jockey, an absolute animal on this Tracer.
Well, in a bit of an atypical defense we've seen from Team Civ so far, just getting rolled right now as Team Jockey with a ton of time moving into this last section, over 5 minutes on the clock still, and right now the defense does not have an answer for the attack.
Down, we do see both Bidley playing that Moira. I like seeing this Moira, especially on this last area, because the corridors are so tight. Psychraw does pop his ult on Zenyatta, but Third Eye Funk Boy just swinging big as best as he can and takes out Kyle Gunner with ease. Geld Capital taking out Kyle Gunner's bongo, that Orisa bongo. And boy, Dirty Jockey's team is just moving this payload so quickly, so efficiently, just doing a very nice job.
And obviously a big part of that is Dirty Jockey, the back here just getting the kills left and right. And just seeming, it does seem like Savuki is the biggest target for him. Once Civ goes down, the rest of the team seems like easy pickings. Another pulse bomb there does go awry, but it clean up just T-Buck as the payload continues to push into this last section. And again, they just don't have an answer for him.
No doubt. Coalescence coming out by Bo Bidley, playing that Moira, but you know, it just doesn't matter. Rayquaza, has he even moved from being on top of that payload? My goodness, seems like he has been there this whole time, just doing a nice job. They are able to clean it up. Just Buck coming out, but unfortunately doesn't do anything for them. And Dirty Jockey's team takes this Junkertown map with 4 minutes and 9 seconds left to go. That is a ton of time, boys, and let's see if Savuki's team can answer.
Yeah, really impressive push for them. And again, just the seeing, I believe it was, we don't have a Dirty Jockey, his replay there queued up. Didn't be able to see a nice play there anyway. But yeah, just a shame not able to see that because he's just in the back line causing all sorts of issues. And yeah, just impressive from him so far. Seems like he's been a little up and down in these games. He's been incredibly influential, obviously, early, and kind of dropped off in some of these, in some of the more recent games, and coming back and again just helping his team get these wins.
Yeah, I believe the problem there with Civ's team is that they try to mirror the pirate ship comp, but the problem is when you set on top of the payload, you have this static comp that is moving with the payload. So if you defend with also the same like immobile comp, the enemy team is advancing anyway towards you. So you don't have you cannot respond quickly to all the damage and the team coming into you. So they should have gotten a more mobile comp, like a Tracer, like a Sombra, something that could like go in their backline and start harassing them.
Attackers incoming. No doubt, I would agree with that. We do see Savuki playing that Hanzo. Kyle Gunner back on D.Va, Just Buck on that Junkrat. Pure Pain is undecided right now, but Bo Bidley back on the Mercy and Psychra on that Zenyatta. Coming in from Dirty Jockey's team, we do have Dirty Jockey on that Tracer, of course. He's only played a touch of Widow, but everything else has been Tracer. And if you've been watching this stream, you can understand why he is phenomenal. Firing Wolf on that Lucio, Guild Capital on the Mercy, Sarge playing that Orisa, Third Eye Funk Boy playing D.Va, which is interesting to see, and Rayquaza back on that Bastion.
and early kills coming in as Sakurai able to take down his opposite support there, and that will be a big pick for the defense as they start here. Dirty Jockey starting cleanup already as Mobility goes down. Pure Paint follows shortly thereafter in a difficult position for the attack without a tank and a healer. Dirty Jockey, their biggest issue though, does fall, and they do have a short response. Maybe we'll take a little bit away from that, but again, just Rayquaza back here on the Bastion getting healed up really well by his supports, Go Capital and Firing Wolf, and yeah, as I say that, then he goes down. But so far, just doing a really, really good job of getting a lot of damage in and causing problems for the attack.
Boy, Savuki's team really needs to account for this Mercy. This Mercy is just tearing them up. They're able to keep him alive. Geld Capital playing Mercy for Team Jockey, excuse me. They're able to keep Geld alive as best as they can, and playing Mercy, just able to put the damage on Rayquaza on that Bastion, and then reviving him. Absolutely big. They need to account for him just a little bit more.
Yeah, but still getting a pretty decent push in as the payload continues to round this corner. Obviously not quite as quickly as the previous attack, but Pure Pain there getting a good kill on the Bastion that again has been just getting quite a bit of damage in, and now getting kills as Kyle Gunner and Justy Buck held him out there to continue wrapping up the rest of these kills. And coming to the edge checkpoint, they'll have quite a bit of time on the clock, actually. Superman tries to come and contest. Fire Wolf now switching to a Junkrat, not something we've seen him play just yet, and he does fall there. Looks like we'll be able to get this checkpoint.
No doubt, but Savuki's team takes that checkpoint with 4 minutes and 50 seconds. That is, I think that's more than what Dirty Jockey's team had. So that's pretty interesting statistic right there. Maybe they'll be able to follow this up and push the payload all the way to the end and have at least 4 minutes and 9 seconds as Dirty Jockey's team was able to do. And right now they're making some big picks. Just Buck taking out Sarge on that Orisa, and it is up 5v6. But now Gale Capital picks Sarge back up and a Diva Bomb goes out, but unfortunately doesn't take anybody out.
And again, just surprising to see Rayquaza stay alive as long as he is without a shield tank in front of him. Third Eye Funk Boy's actions and pseudo shield tank with that defense matrix able to keep him from getting too much damage, but sitting basic here right here in the center. Oh my god,
poor man. That's a 4 Diva pick! Bomb.
That was amazing. Amazing Third Eye just completely shut down this attack in its tracks, and it's just well placed for him.
Damn.
That was amazing. Third Eye Funk Boy just sending out that Diva Bomb, saying, catch this, and boom! Kills four of Savuki.
GG!
Yeah, exactly.
Man, what an ultimate to go effectively just shut down that fight, really before it even started.
No doubt, and Dirty Jockey's team, they are able to get back onto that point, and of course, Rayquaza establishing where he lives, and that is on top of the payload, it seems like, behind a shield, and Sarge shielding him on that Orisa. Rayquaza protecting that payload as best as he can, throwing out some fire, some damage as that Bastion, but right now, Sarge throws down that Bongo, but really without anybody to be looking at or shooting, because Team Savuki's team did pull back, and that's a big pick right now by Just T-Buck. Just T-Buck just takes out Dirty Jockey, and maybe they can capitalize on this and move forward a little bit.
I was surprised by that Supercharger. I like the positioning of it a lot. It was in a tucked away spot, but still able to access the rest of the team pretty easily. But yeah, you're exactly right. Nobody had engaged yet, so a bit of a waste for them, but still getting the kills. The team said did wait for that to go down. Now Pure Pain coming in with a Hole Hog, able to pick up one, and Kyle Gunner getting one either side, so Savuki and Sakura adding in. That was an effective push there from the attack, just really combined well to get those kills, and not having to contend with that Supercharger must have helped.
Yeah, very nice job by Savuki's team, and as you can see, he is on fire playing Hanzo. Very nice job by Savuki, and you can tell he just picked off Rayquaza. I'm surprised Rayquaza changed from Bastion and is now on Junkrat. That is shocking to me. He was doing such a nice job on Junkrat, and now Dirty Jockey trying to contest the payload as best as he can, and of course does get picked off very easily by Kyle Gunner because nobody was paying attention to him. And now here we go with Psychro coming out with a Transcendence on that Zenyatta. Big plays happening. Pure Pain taking out Guild Capital on that Mercy. Huge things happening on that payload right now. But Savuki's team, it seems like a fairly even fight, just going back and forth and back and forth. Both Dirty Jockey and Savuki's team. And Kyle Gunner sending out that Diva Bomb, but unfortunately not able to capitalize on it because he doesn't pick anybody. But lots of things happen. Savuki's team coming back. They do establish the high ground. Pure Pain throws out the hook, but unfortunately misses somebody. And a big Junkrat Riptire coming in by Just T-Buck, taking out both the supports. They should be able to win this fight now, advance this payload, and get this next point.
Well, in that Riptide was huge because it prevented Fire and Wolf from being able to get that sound barrier off. He was in the middle of doing his ultimate and died midair before he hit the ground. He was not able to get the healing to his team, and I believe lost that ult as well. So just a huge Riptide there from Just T-Buck to make sure they won that fight, and they were able to cap that checkpoint. Not as much time on the clock to contend with Darty at a point lower in the time bank than Team Jockey has coming into this. So a bit of a disadvantage, but still ults to work with. Rather than one ult there, Cycro's about to get another transcendence and could still force the round three here.
No doubt. If Savuki's team could capture this, they could, of course, force that round three, as Sultan said. Speaking of forcing that round three, stay tuned for after this game. We've got a special announcement from the OWX League, but right now we're back to the action. Lots of action happening on the point. Savuki's team trying to make those picks, but unfortunately unable to do so. Big pick, big hog hook coming in by Pure Pain. Unfortunately, being peeled by D.Va, that Junkrat was, and Pure Pain takes out Rayquaz on that Junkrat. Savuki switching over, playing that Tracer, takes out Sarge on that Monkey, and a big picks coming in for both teams happening right now.
Yeah, force the Valkyrie from Geld Capital able to pick up two to get them back in this fight. But Psychron now, it's DPS and Yada going off, grabbing two in the feed, Kyogunner adding another, and Third Eye trying to answer back. But right now the attack from Civ's team, it looks like they are pushing really well and getting the kills they need to continue this payload push into the last section, and they'll need all the time they can get at this point now, having to contend with the 4 minutes and 9 seconds from Jerky Jockey's team.
No doubt, and as you can see, Kyogunner is on fire, and that is because he is flexing on Dirty Jockey's team, just doing a very nice job on D.Va right now. And Savuki takes out Rayquaz on that soldier, but Dirty Jockey taking out Psychra. That's a big pick on that support. Savuki taking out Guild Capital, huge pick for that for his team, and he takes out Dirty Jockey as well. You know that's a huge pick, and he has a smile on his face from that.
And again, nobody wanted to fall too much, but Civ finally getting Firing Wolf, and with a couple ults working here for the attack, they could be able to push the rest of the team back. The D.Va Bomb will go off, doesn't quite connect, or rather gets Kyogunner out of the back. Third at Funk Boy probably wanted something a little bit similar to the one he had a little bit ago. But the fight all over the place, you see three members of Civ's team much further back from the point, no one really on the payload, and the defenders pushing up here a little bit further. The defenders do have time to come back into this point, but again, just every second they take to get into the point is another one lost on the bank for them relative to that huge amount of time that Dirty Jog his team has, so we'll have to be similar about how to do this. They do have a couple ultimates to work with, and I believe we'll have like five probably about as you know when this next fight breaks out.
Yep.
Yeah, no doubt. Savuki's team, they are banking on these ultimates to come out. Pure Pain does send out a hog ult. Kyogunner sends out his D.Va, does pick up Rayquaz. That's a nice pick right now. They're down to one ult right now. Huge pick by Just Buck. Takes out both the Mercy and the D.Va right now. Pure Pain and Kyogunner taking out Firing Wolf. Lots of action happening on this payload. They should be able to push this in with a slight amount of time on at the end so they can force it into overtime. Nobody's on the payload. Get on the payload.
Oh, that may have cost them right there. Sarge is able to get the res on the point. If they don't cap this, that may be influential for them. 0.87 meters away, and everybody got off the point, and now the defense can come back into contest. And now it's just a few on the point. So Third Eye Funk Boy goes out of Mech. Firing Wolf still trying to keep alive here on the point, but it looks like the attack may be able to overrun them here, but still able to keep the contest up with the short respawn. I'm so surprised they got off the point there.
I can't believe it. C9, but right now they need to stay on this payload if they want to try and capitalize on it. 0.87 meters to go. They are just barely away. They could step forward and capitalize, and there it is. Round two complete. They are able to capture it. They do have a minute left on the clock. Two Dirty Jockeys team of 5 minutes and 9 seconds. Whew. What an all-star game, folks.
And getting the minute added, I think that was just Dirty Jockeys team stepping off for just the slightest of seconds. 0.87 meters away. It didn't take much with that payload to push into the final section. So now everything to play for here. A lot of time in the bank for Dirty Jockeys team, and so we'll have to see something impressive from Civ's team if they want to come away from the all-star game with the win in the final round.
You can see Savuki is going back to that Tracer. He was just popping off. If you were watching that kill feed, Savuki was just cleaning up. Dirty Jockey again playing that Tracer as well. Just Buck playing the Junkrat. Pure Pain back on the Roadhog. Bo Biddley back on the Mercy. Psychra on that Zenyatta. And Kyogunner, I'm going to guess that he's going to play D.Va again because he sure was flexing on Dirty Jockey's team. Speaking of Dirty Jockey's team, they have Dirty Jockey again on Tracer. Firing Wolf back on that Lucio Gale Capital on the Mercy. Sarge back on Orisa. Third Eye Funk Boy on that D.Va. And Rayquaz back on the Bastion.
That's all to play for here. Coming into the final round, just a minute to work with for the attack. And we'll see if they have it in them to try and get a little bit of purchase and then pull up a just a defense of their lives to get something away from this game.
Raise your thanks have happened, and I bet Ziff's team, if they can play as a cohesive unit and account for Dirty Jockey, they will be able to push this payload quite the ways. They do have to contend with that 5 minutes and 9 seconds that Dirty Jockey's team does have, but they need to be on this payload. They need to be pushing it as far as they can.
Well, that's a question. How well can they contend with Dirty Jockey in the back just causing problems, and does end up getting the kill there on Sinfuki, and that's going to be big for them. Pure Payload able to answer back as Dirty Jockey continues to go to work, picking up Just T-Buck. So now disadvantage. It's a four-man for the attack against the five on defense here, and could be in a really difficult spot trying to answer back as Third Eye Funkboy finally does go out of back there. Pure Pain able to get a good pick on him, but once again, Dirty Jockey just causing all the problems for the attackers.
This guy is an animal. Dirty Jockey just cleaning up right now. But Savuki does answer as soon as we say something. Savuki takes out Dirty Jockey. Savuki's team, they do have most of their team up right now, while Team Dirty Jockey, they are missing several characters on their team. Savuki's team will be able to push this payload for quite a ways.
Yeah, as it goes into overtime, a huge, huge pick there on Geld Capital, who out of Valkyrie was not able to use it. As soon as he earned it, I believe, did get taken down, so was able to keep the team alive. And that could have been hugely influential with the rests coming to this next point, especially with the ultimates they have on their side. But they may be able to get into this point unless Dirty Jockey is able to continue to contest. Use the pulse bomb there and the recall, so doesn't have that on respawn. And now Spoke Goodly, who will not be able to help with the ult here at about 10% or so. Kyle Gunner using a self-destruct, both self-destructs coming out. I believe Fire Wolf gets caught in one. And yeah, just kills going either side, 4.7 meters away.
Rage no doubt, but Dirty Jockey just cleaning up right now. Takes out Just T-Buck, takes out Kyle Gunner's mech, and then follows up with taking out Kyle Gunner. Savuki tried to come in, but Rayquist says, no, no, no. Owes him right down with that Bastion. And there you have it, folks. Savuki's team, they were able to push at 86.x meters down the line, but Dirty Jockey's team does have that 5 minutes and 9 seconds. Will Savuki's defense be able to withstand that time?
Well, we'll have to see something really, really impressive from the defense from Team Civ to hold on to the amount of kind of real estate they're taking up with the payload here with 5 minutes to contend with. People, what do you think?
Well, I think it's going to be tough, but this is a really close game. And I think in order to be able to defend this, they have to go like total, like super strong defensive, like a lot of damage coming in. And they have to watch out for Dirty Jockey, man. Dirty Jockey just gets behind them and just cleans up.
Interesting switch here for the defensive Civ, now switching to Zarya.
It's like if they have a Junkrat, just put like a trap behind them.
I like their defense right now. We do see a triple tank composition coming in. Savuki playing that Zarya, Kyle on that Orisa, Just T-Buck playing that Lucio, which we saw him play very well earlier. Pure Pain back on the Roadhog, Bo Biddley on the Mercy, and Psych Raw playing that Bastion. They're going to try everything that they can from stopping Dirty Jockey's team from advancing that payload.
Well, we could be in for a treat here. A really impressive defense, or it could be a short round. This will be the last round of the game, going to the fourth game here. Have the announcement afterwards, so stick around for that. But just excited to see what these teams have for us in the final round on Junkertown.
Oh, wow, very nice job. Rayquist just popping on, establishing where he lives, and that is on top of the payload. And Sarge just giving that Orisa shield on him as well. Big pick happening by Sarge on Psych Raw, but Psych Raw does get revived by Bo Biddley. Boy, Civ's team really needs to get some picks here to push Team Dirty Jockey back.
Yeah, Pure Pain grabs Firing Wolf, who just overextended just a little bit. Rayquist will answer back on Kyle Gunner, though, but two important kills there as Firing Wolf does get resurrected, and I'm kind of surprised that Geld Capital was able to get into that position. But still, the payload inching ever further forward as Rayquist is behind both those double shields, just continues to shred the rest of this defense.
Oh! Huge coming in! Third Eye Funkboy able to get on top just by jumping up from Savuki's, looks like his Zarya bomb, and he was able to get on top, have a huge pin on the opposing team. Right now you can see Pure Pain sort of hiding in the background, looking for that pick. He's trying to be super sneaky. He's looking after that Mercy. I can tell he wants that Mercy. He wants that Mercy bad. He's gonna be throwing that hook here pretty soon. And he missed the hook on the Bastion. I was wrong. Huge pick by Dirty Jockey. Pulse bomb on both the Mercy and the Bastion. Pure Pain coming back, picking off Rayquist, but unfortunately he gets taken down by Sarge, and I believe that's gonna be all she wrote, folks.
And there you have it, Dirty Jockey's team coming in and getting the final round on Junkertown, and with 5 minutes in the bank, I feel like it was going to be a foregone conclusion. Very difficult for them to come back from that, but congratulations to them for winning the All-Star game and just this four-man D.Va bomb. Third at Funkboy.
We'll get everybody's opinion after this, and then we'll move on with the next Overwatch League announcement. super fun all-star game, boys. I've had a ton of fun. I hope you guys have too. This has been great.
Yeah, just hotly contested games, and just exciting to see what Season 3 has in store for us. Obviously, all these players coming through Season 2, some of the best players in the league, and excited to see them go up against each other for the kind of curtain closer for the season. But we'll take a quick break and come right back with all of our post-game goodness. We'll be right back. We are back, and what an all-star game. Team Jockey edging out the victory 2-1 over Team Civ after John Eichenwald, and I don't think we could have asked for a better all-star game. Raging, what do you think?
Oh my goodness, I can't tell you how much fun I've had. This has been a ton of fun. You know, exactly what we were interested in, exactly what we expected. Expectations versus reality, they matched equally. Team Civ versus Team Jockey, they went draw, and then Team Jockey just squeaks it out there at the end. Fantastic game by both sides.
Just impressive to see from them. Pivo, SK, what do you guys think? What did you see?
I really enjoyed it. It was such like a contested game all over. Like, all the maps were very contested. The only thing was that the very last time, the very last defense that Team Civ did, they ran a triple tank against the Bastion. If Bastion is good at one thing, it's shredding tanks. So they just fed the Bastion with the biggest targets they could, which is a triple tanking. So it was maybe not the best decision they could have done there at the end, but it was a great series overall. Like, I really had a lot of fun.
Absolutely.
And man, Dirty Jockey is just annoying as Tracer. Damn.
He's a phenomenal Tracer.
Yeah, just running Riot apps. I think just on a level by himself there. And they had a really difficult time. He definitely has to be my MVP of the game, just leading his team to this victory. Obviously, a lot of great play all the way around. But yeah, Dirty Jockey just cleaning up in the back and showing us how it's done on Tracer. So good to see that content there. Yeah, really fun game, really exciting. Like we said, Season 3 will be starting on January the 1st. Make sure you are on the free agent list, and you can get